Peace to everybody. How you guys doing today? I hope everyone's having a beautiful day. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new, I am Maya Melrose and I focus on beauty, soul, holistic health, lifestyle tips. And today I want to do a little bit of catching up because over these past few months has been really hectic with my time and energy and everything that I haven't been able to do like a current update. Everything I've been kind of uploading is kind of backed up content, so I just wanted to share. I have so much to share, so much that I've been growing and learning from over the summer and past few weeks, past few days, really. And so, yeah, I just wanted to share that because it's a lot of good, helpful insight that can help you on your journey and what I'm doing on my journey to help me move forward and to eliminate everything that's not gonna essentially help me in the long run, right? So today's video, I wanted to focus on how to eliminate distractions. And this is key point to me. I just literally did a whole journal entry. I want to start doing journal entry sharings with you guys because I do a lot. I get a lot of intuitive insight when I write in my journals, and I get a lot of highly intuitive advice through myself, using myself as a resource when I do intuitive writing in my journal. So one of the things I wanted to talk about was the distractions. Right now, I feel that I'm at a cross point in my life where I have this old energy. I have the old energy on how I used to be, think, everything, do, the people who I involved myself with, the activities I did, the mindset I had, the overall energy of who I used to be, right? And then I have this new blossoming, flourishing goddess energy that's waiting for me to tap in to as soon as I let go of all this old baggage and stuff, right? So I've been in the process of trying to separate the two and in the process of trying to let all of this old energy go for good once and for all and not to dib and dabble between both energies, you know? One thing with eliminating distractions, first you have to become aware of what is distracting you from your purpose. And most of the time, if we are not being aware and conscious, we are too caught up in the distractions to even know that it is a distraction. And why this is very essential to your growth and essential to your energy is because every new level that you ascend to, everything you grow out of and everything, there's always going to be new tests, new distractions, new hindrances. It's going to be things to sway you off course on that level that corresponds to your energy. You know what I'm saying? So you always have to be aware of what's in my life that's being presented to me that I'm around that is not really essentially helping me and is taking me away from my purpose. And sometimes the distractions are pleasures. And sometimes those pleasures aren't always healthy pleasures. Just because it feels good and just because it gives you a temporary satisfaction of fake happiness, that doesn't mean it's essentially well for your overall being. And especially with now in this time, we don't have any time to waste. So you really, 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 really have to be conscious and aware of yourself on all levels. And it starts with identifying what are your weaknesses and what are your distractions that are holding you back from that next level. Once you're able to identify those weaknesses and those distractions, now you're able to eliminate them out your life. You're able to be aware of when that energy is being presented in your reality, and you're able to discern whether this situation, experience, or person is going to help move you forward, or they're helping you distract you from your purpose. So one thing that was helping me in my journal exercise, I named it, let me just go ahead and read it because I'll give you guys all the juice. I called it Which Side 50-50, right? And basically this is a dialogue between myself, but on different perspectives. I'm having a communication with different perspectives within myself. So then now when I look back at it, I can see where was that energy stemming from for me to create that perspective. And it's really been helping me to identify what energy is true and what energy is right. because we have so many thoughts, ideas, energies playing in our overall being that we have to be able to decipher what energy is best to play out so that I'm able to perfect my desired path and purpose, soul purpose, life purpose, all of that. You know? So seeing that in front of you to be able to pick, to be able to see the different perspectives that you are feeling at that moment is very helpful. You can't deny anything. You can't deny those thoughts. You can't deny those emotions and feelings. You have to be honest with yourself and let those emotions and stuff be present. Let whatever is bothering you be present. And when I say different perspectives, so honestly for me, when I did on my journal entry, I can tell the difference between my higher self and my lower self, my ego versus my soul, my heart versus my mind. I see the difference on where those perspectives were stemming from or what they was created around, you know? So I did that. I was doing a journal exercising, and that's what led me into do the sharing of this video, because for example, this is something else I wanted to share. I notice anytime I claim I am happy, I promise you the next day I'm like mad depressed, mad just weird out of my like happiness, right? And I figured it out through the journaling too. I figured it out. I was like, as soon as you claim something and you project it out into the universe, there's going to be a positive charge and then there's going to be a negative charge. And based on what your energy is fueling more to the charge is what will play out in your reality. I hope I said that clear. So example, I said, boom, I'm happy. Anytime I'm like, oh, I'm in a good space, I'm happy, I'm joyful, that positive charge is going to be sent out into the universe so that those energies are able to be reciprocated into my reality, because that's how I feel at the moment, right? And then it's also going to be a negative charge to test to see if I'm really feeling that way, to see if I'm really embodying that energy to surpass and go to the next level. You know what I'm saying? So that's with everything. So once you claim something into the universe, once you put it out there, once you project your energy out there, you have to fuel, which you have to charge the energy that you want most to be played out into your reality. So if you say, oh, I'm happy, but you have feelings of negativity, or you have doubt, or you feel like, oh, I'm happy, but I need this, or there's some type of, you know, negative thing to it, that negative charge is gonna come back and manifest into your reality, because that's what you gave more energy to. If you really are happy and you really are like in a good space, mentally, physically, and spiritually, you're gonna give that energy more to the positive charge, and then that positive charge is gonna play out into your reality with more happy moments. So depending on what you're projecting out, and whatever energy you give your energy to the most is what will play out in your reality. So with that said, once you claim like, oh, I surpassed this level, or I'm not this way anymore, or I don't need that old energy anymore, you just put out the charge that, okay, you are ready to grow, you are ready to surpass this level and go to the next test and go to the next ascension level. And then you're also putting out that test to be projected out into the universe to see how much did you change. If we, you know, everything's just a test. Once you claim something, you're gonna be tested for it. You're gonna be rewarded for it, and you're also gonna be tested for it. Boom. That's what I figured out in life. And whatever you give your energy more to is what will play out in your reality. So when you're claiming that you are this evolved human, you're not stuck in your old ways, you're not stuck in your old energies, you're going to have that charge be sent out positively. That's going to manifest back into your reality where you'll have things that actually support that belief system. And then you're also going to have that negative charge that's going to test you to see how serious are you about this, giving up the old energy. The universe, most high, is going to place something that involved the old energy, that, you know, that whole old energy set, that they're going to place into your current reality to test you to see, are you really done with this old energy? Or did you fake it? You know what I'm saying? So what charge are you giving the most energy to play out in your reality? And once I realized that, I was like, oh God, that makes so much sense. It makes so much sense. And now I can apply that to every aspect of my life. I know that whatever I claim, I have to really, really, really mean it. And I have to believe it. And I have to know it. I have to know it. Not even believe it. I have to know it. So that when those tests come, I'm able to pass them with flying colors, because I embodied what I'm claiming. I keep my word to myself and to the Most Highs, and to the universe, to everything around me, right? That's what is happening. So in this ascension process, in this process of bettering yourself and tapping into the greatest version of yourself, you're going to be hit with so many distractions along the way that you have to know what is a distraction, how to eliminate it, how to discern whether it's good for you or bad for you, and how to just keep it moving, how to keep it pushing. So be conscious and be aware of what it is that it distracts you. Once this energy is present into your reality, really be conscious and aware and discern, is this going to help me or is this going to take me away from my purpose? And you have to ask yourself how serious you are about you and your path, you and your purpose. Is this distraction worth taking you away from your true purpose? Or is starving the distraction and feeding your focus worth it? So these are moments that are going to happen in your life continuously. It's happening in mine. And I'm wise enough now to not get caught up in these same energy traps, to have to learn a lesson a hard way. I'm wise enough to be conscious and aware of old patterns, old energies, old behaviors, old ways of being, thinking, doing. And I'm aware to know I deserve better, I am better, and I am past that. So though those distractions may be tempting and may, that's another thing too. Oh gosh. Whew, those tests of distractions are always tempting. It's always gonna be the temptation you're always gonna be tempted by the temptation that you need to be tested by. Yes, you're always going to be tempted by the temptation that you need to be tested by. And what? Yeah. So these distractions are going to come with your greatest temptations to really test you to see if you outgrown this level in life. It's so simple, but it gets so hard. It gets difficult at times because we're human. We have emotions, we have attachments, we have pleasures. And when you mix that into the mix, it gets a little difficult sometimes. So, gotta discern what's best for you. And you have to know that distractions are always gonna be around. You have to be strong enough to know, hey, I'm identifying this, I'm better than this, and now let's move forward to something that's going to put me into a greater position. So another helpful exercise that I did in my journal was to list out all of my distractions on things that take me away from my soul purpose, and I also listed things that help me bring me closer to my soul purpose and my life purpose. And I can look at that list and just know boom, I can't involve my energy in these certain things because it takes me away from my purpose. And if I do involve my energy in those things, I have to ask, what are you doing? You're better than that. You know what I'm saying? We have to eliminate that. So, yeah. Then I have the list of things that do help me. So every day I can make sure that I am doing something off that list that's going to help bring me closer to my soul purpose. And essentially, it overall helps you as an individual. It allows you to honor yourself and honor your worth and honor your energy and respect your energy and to respect the space and time and where you're at right now. And just being aware and having insights on your shadow self and your, you know, like the dark sides of you that doesn't get addressed, and you are honest with yourself, everything will work out. You won't have to get caught up in tests and allow these distractions to sway you off course. Set goals for yourself. Set a goal point. Set some focal points for yourself so that you are able to be focused on what it is that you need to have your attention on. And especially with your purpose, it's time for all of us to tap into our purpose and our greatest purpose on why we are here. It's time for us to be that greatest version of ourselves and to stop allowing these illusions and these distractions to get the best of us and to sway us off course from being the greatest version of ourselves. So, you know, all of this, it's all a form of self-love, and you want to make sure you're loving yourself properly, and you want to be able to give yourself the right comforting love that your soul needs so that you're able to keep riding along your journey in harmony. And yeah, just set those goal points, set those focal points so that you are so focused. These little distractions that are on the side coming in your way, trying to sway you off course, they can't even get by you because you're so focused. Set a reason on why you are focused on this purpose. And don't let yourself or anyone else distract you from achieving this and becoming the greatest version of yourself. Okay? Don't let anyone distract you from tapping into your goddess or your godly flow. Okay, everyone? All right, love yourself to the fullest and take yourself seriously. Show up for yourself wholeheartedly, 100%. Don't half-ass nothing in your journey, okay? Because you don't deserve that. You deserve the top-notch, classiest, most best of everything. All right, so next time you feel that you are being distracted, step back, be still. Be aware, be conscious, and ask yourself, is this going to help me move me forward or is it going to take me back? What is it that I want out of life? And if you, I'm pretty sure everybody wants to move forward, be happy, and be the best version of themselves, right? So is that distraction worth taking that away? And 10 times out of 10, it's going to be no. So do it. Another thing with tapping into yourself is that you want to make sure you know when to let go of things. When to let go of things plays an important role in your journey when developing the best version of yourself. Knowing when to let go and knowing when to respect time and energy is very vital to your growth, because it's going to be things along your journey and along your way that you're going to have to learn to let go. And like I said, we are humans. We're attached to things. We have emotions. We have feelings to things. So sometimes that's not the easiest to do. And you have to respect that, though. And this is where faith comes in. You have to know that though I'm leaving this, there is something way better for me when I leave this. I'm always going to be taken care of. I'm always going to be presented with the best opportunities to move me to where it is that I want to be in life. That's where faith comes in at, and when you have a knowing that no matter what, you'll be okay. you'll be okay in the end. You'll be okay in the process. You'll be okay all around. It's having the faith and knowing. And knowing that you are covered. Okay, so knowing how to discern your distractions and knowing when to let go of them so that you are no longer distracted by them is very key and very vital. And if you have a hard time doing that, ask for guidance. Ask for clarity. Ask for awareness levels so that you're able to decipher this for yourself and discern for yourself. Yeah. Okay. All right. That's pretty much it for this. Until next time, love and blessings to everybody. Peace.